using their margin structure to maintain.
Evaristus Jn Marie says although it would be difficult to give insightful comments regarding the sale of Hess oil without more details of the transaction, he warns that prices at the pumps may go up.
So far as it relates to the storage facilities being made available to the marketing companies, which is Rubis and Sol, and that the whole pricing structure insofar as renting those facilities do remain intact. Because failing this, if these things change and they change in a negative way, meaning that the prices of the, goes up or the storage facilities reduce, then it may have implications for the whole pricing of fuel. If the marketing company's costs go up by virtue of those changes, then before long it wouldn't be surprising if they began to make representation to government for changes in their margin structure to maintain their level of profitability.
Hess Corporation is a leading global independent energy company engaged in the exploration and production of crude oil and natural gas. The facility, located at Cul-de-Sac, stores crude oil and refined products. It includes a transshipment terminal. The director of corporate communications of Hess Corporation in the United States, Danny Moynihan, says that sometime in March, the company had announced its intention to exit the entire downstream market and to focus more on becoming an exploration and production company.
The sale of the terminal network, along with the sales of four upstream producing assets completed earlier this year, and the announced sale of the energy marketing business, brings total year-to-date divestitures to $5.4 billion. Hess has used the initial proceeds from its completed asset sale first to repay debt and then to further strengthen its balance sheet.
Mr. Moynihan says the sale of the company's local assets is part of the company's growth strategy. And for the former president of the Petroleum Dealers Association, the sale of Hess Oil is a major blow to the island.
There's no doubt about it that since the advent of Hess, there's been a very strong relationship between Hess and the government of St. Lucia. I mean, we have the evidence is all around in terms of what they have done for education, and it is a loss, and we need to recognize that they have been very good corporate, exemplary corporate citizens, and I think as a country we need to be thankful for that and to recognize it.
As a result of the sale, Hess is expected separately to release approximately $900 million of working capital, with another $100 million continuing to be retained by the retail business as part of its ongoing operations. For the DBS News World, Jason Hullingseed reporting.